In the land of plenty, where supermarket shelves overflow with an endless array of edible options, one would assume that the nourishment we consume is wholesome, nutritious, and true to its natural form. Regrettably, this is far from the reality facing the average American today. A disturbing trend has emerged where the food industry has mastered the art of deception, luring consumers into purchasing products that are anything but real food. The proliferation of highly processed, chemically laden, and nutritionally void items, masquerading as food, has become a pervasive issue in the United States. From the moment we step into a grocery store, we are bombarded with slick marketing tactics, misleading labels, and sophisticated formulations designed to appeal to our senses and exploit our desire for convenience. This insidious practice has effectively eroded our understanding of what constitutes genuine, unadulterated sustenance, leaving us vulnerable to the allure of fake food. At the heart of this problem lies the relentless pursuit of profit by major food corporations. In their quest to maximize shareholder returns, these big food corporations have prioritized cutting costs, making their products last longer on the shelves, and creating highly processed Frankenfoods over actually providing nutritious, healthy food. They've done this by lobbying the government, manipulating regulations, and exploiting our psychology as consumers. This has allowed them to dominate the food landscape, pushing real whole foods to the sidelines. The proliferation of ultra-processed products, laden with artificial additives, preservatives, and synthetic flavors, has become the norm rather than the exception. These highly engineered concoctions bear little resemblance to the whole, nutrient-dense ingredients that once sustained our ancestors. Yet, through the power of marketing and the manipulation of our taste buds, they have become the dietary staples of millions of Americans. The food in your kitchen cabinets may not be what it seems, warns Larry Olmsted, author of the book Real Food, Fake Food. Fraudsters motivated by economic gain secretly infiltrate the global food market through a variety of means, including counterfeits, dilutions, substitution, and mislabeling. The deception extends beyond the mere composition of these products. It also permeates the language used to describe them. Clever labeling and misleading claims, such as natural, organic, or healthy, have become commonplace, lulling consumers into a false sense of security and obscuring the true nature of the items they are purchasing. This obfuscation of information not only undermines our ability to make informed choices, but also erodes the trust that should be the foundation of our relationship with the food industry. Moreover, the proliferation of fake food has had far-reaching consequences that extend beyond individual health. The environmental impact of industrial agriculture, the exploitation of vulnerable communities, and the erosion of local food systems have all been exacerbated by the relentless pursuit of profit at the expense of genuine sustenance. As the distance between the consumer and the source of their food continues to grow, the disconnect between what we eat and the true cost of its production has become increasingly apparent. Some estimates say food fraud affects at least 1% of the global food industry, at a cost as high as $40 billion a year, according to the Food and Drug Administration, reports CNBC Africa. The Grocery Manufacturers of America has even estimated that 10% of the commercially available food in the United States is adulterated. That means if you're not carefully scrutinizing every item in your shopping cart, there's a good chance you're bringing home something that's not what it seems. The impact of this deception on public health is nothing short of staggering. As Americans continue to consume these Frankenfoods, the rates of obesity, diabetes, and other chronic diseases have skyrocketed, placing an immense burden on our healthcare system and eroding the overall well-being of our population. Food fraud not only harms consumers' wallets, it puts their health and safety at risk, warns the CNBC Africa report. The report cites examples of seafood being mislabeled, Parmesan cheese products containing no actual Parmesan, and extra virgin olive oils being diluted with cheaper oils. These practices not only deprive consumers of the nutrients they expect, but can also expose them to potential allergens or contaminants. The situation has become so dire that even the U.S. Pharmacopeia Convention, a nonprofit organization that sets standards for the quality, purity, and safety of medicines and foods, has stepped in to provide a framework for organizations to detect and mitigate food fraud vulnerabilities. This underscores the severity of the problem and the urgent need for action. But the food industry's deception goes beyond mere mislabeling and adulteration. The rise of the wellness and clean eating trends has also been exploited by savvy marketers who have capitalized on our desire for healthier options by creating a new generation of fake food that is often just as unhealthy as the processed junk it seeks to replace. The food industry has become more of a trend industry than a nutrition industry, laments Dr. David Katz, the founding director of the Yale Griffin Prevention Research Center. They're creating foods that look healthy, that are marketed as healthy, but are often just as bad or worse than the processed foods they're trying to replace. These so-called health foods are often laden with added sugars, artificial sweeteners, and other questionable ingredients, all wrapped up in sleek packaging and clever branding that plays on our desire for a quick fix to our dietary woes. From protein bars and superfood smoothies to clean ice creams and guilt-free snacks, the shelves are teeming with products that promise wellness, but deliver little more than empty calories and a false sense of security. It's that simple, warns Larry Olmsted. Anytime a product can be passed off as something more expensive, it will be. And the food industry has become masters of this deception, exploiting our vulnerabilities and our desire for convenience to line their pockets at the expense of our health. Reclaiming our food sovereignty and restoring the integrity of our food system will require a multifaceted approach. It will necessitate a concerted effort to educate and empower consumers, to hold the food industry accountable for its deceptive practices, and to champion policies that prioritize the well-being of both people and the planet over the bottom line. Through grassroots movements, community-based initiatives, and a renewed emphasis on the importance of whole, locally sourced foods, we can begin to dismantle the illusion of sustenance that has been so carefully crafted by the purveyors of fake food. By reconnecting with the origins of our sustenance and rediscovering the joy and nourishment that comes from real, unadulterated ingredients, we can reclaim our health, our communities, and our rightful place as stewards of a food system that truly serves the needs of all. The battle against fake food may be an uphill one, but it is a fight worth waging. For in doing so, we not only safeguard our own well-being, but also pave the way for a future where the sustenance we consume is a true reflection of the bounty of the earth and the wisdom of our ancestors. It is time to reclaim our food, our health, and our rightful place as conscious, discerning consumers in a world that has, for far too long, prioritized profit over the fundamental human need for genuine, life-sustaining nourishment. The stakes have never been higher, and the consequences of our inaction have never been more dire. The time to act is now, before the very fabric of our health and well-being is irrevocably torn asunder by the relentless onslaught of fake food and the industry that seeks to profit from our demise. Will we rise to the challenge, or will we succumb to the siren call of convenience and the false promises of a food system that cares more for its bottom line than for our well-being? The choice is ours, but the clock is ticking. The future of our health, our communities, and our very way of life depends on it. If you found this information eye-opening, be sure to subscribe and share with your friends and family. Together, we can spread awareness and empower each other to make more informed choices when it comes to the sustenance we consume.